Now, in this video, we'll study about the internal structure of the human heart. Now, human heart is completely four-chambered heart where it contains two auricles and two ventricles. So, this is called as the right auricle, this is the left auricle, this is the right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. Now, auricles are called as auricles are the upper chamber and ventricles are the lower chamber. Auricles are called as the receiving chambers and ventricles are called as the distributing chambers. Because from different, say right auricles, from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, blood is coming into the right auricle. And from pulmonary vein, blood is coming into the left auricle. So basically it receives the blood, so it is called as a receiving chamber. And ventricle that distributes the blood goes out of the body from ventricle, so it is called as a distributing chamber. Now we'll see in detail the structure of this human heart. So already as I said, it is a four chambered, so which contains two auricle and two ventricle. Now human circulatory system that is called as a closed circulatory system. Again that we have studied in the previous video, it is a closed circulatory system. Meaning blood flows from the blood vessel, strictly from the blood vessel. Alright, now what happens into the right auricle? In the right auricle, blood is collected from the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava and from this coronary sinus. Superior vena cava collects the blood from the upper part of the body, inferior vena cava from the lower part of the body, and coronary sinus that collects or that gives the blood into right auricle from the cardiac muscles or from the heart itself. The deoxygenated blood, from all this part the deoxygenated blood is coming into the right auricle. So superior part say, inferior part say, deoxygenated blood is coming into the right auricle. Now heart is also an organ, so which also requires the blood. So all the deoxygenated blood from the heart wall or from the heart itself will be collected from this coronary sinus. Now from right auricle, the deoxygenated blood will go into the right ventricle by this tricuspid valve. Now tricuspid valve, why it is called as a tricuspid valve? Because this is having the three cusps. So this is having three cusps and heads. Hence this is called as a tricuspid valve. So to the right side, that is called as a atrioventricular valve because it is in between auricle and ventricle. So it is called as a AV valve that is present in between right auricle and right ventricle. Now from here the blood will come into the right ventricle and from right ventricle it will go, this green color here you can see, into the pulmonary artery for oxygenation. Now it will give blood to the lungs for the process of oxygenation. Now remember, pulmonary artery is the only artery which is carrying this deoxygenated blood. Sirf ek hi artery aisi body mein hai jo deoxygenated blood carry karte hai. Baki sabhi arteries basically carry the oxygenated blood, but this is the only artery which is carrying the deoxygenated blood. Now from here it will go to the lungs, it will undergo oxygenation and the oxygenated blood will come into the left auricle via this pulmonary vein. Again remember, pulmonary vein, it is the only vein which is carrying the oxygenated blood. Baki remaining all other veins which carry the deoxygenated. Now the deoxygenated blood will come here in the left auricle, from left auricle through this bicuspid valve, here you can see, through this bicuspid valve it will come into the left ventricle. Now from left ventricle it will go into the aorta. यहाँ पे जो है मैं ये सब निकाल देती हूँ यहाँ से. So from this it will go into the aorta. Aorta that is the biggest artery of the body, and again this aorta is guarded by the valve which is called as a aortic semilunar valve. From here it will go for the systemic circulation, and from this green color, here again if I draw this green color, ye sab main agar nikal deti hu, so this green color which will carry the deoxygenated blood to the lung for the process of oxygenation. So that is called as a pulmonary circulation. And hence, circulation in the heart is called as a double circulation, because it go for the systemic circulation. All the organ will get the oxygenated blood, they will use the oxygenated blood, and the deoxygenated blood will come back into the heart from the superior and inferior vena. And it will go for oxygenation through this artery, that is called as a pulmonary circulation. So blood comes twice in the heart, and hence human circulation is called as a double circulation. Alright, now we have studied the four chambers in detail. Again, we summarize the four valve. Now four valve, as already I have said, it is a tricuspid valve. It is present in between the right auricle and ventricle, and bicuspid valve, which is present in the left auricle and ventricle, which is also called as a mitral valve. Now other, these are called as a atrioventricular valve. Now these are called as these two, pulmonary semilunar valve and aortic semilunar valve. They are called as a semilunar valve. Pulmonary semilunar kahan pe present hota hai? That is in this pulmonary artery. Yahan pe present rahega pulmonary semilunar valve, or in aorta, yahan pe in the opening of aorta there is a aortic semilunar valve. Now this valve, this bicuspid valve, is held at the proper position because of the spring, which is called as a chordae tendineae. The margin is uneven here, you can see, and there is a little bulging on this margin from where this chordae tendineae arises. This is the bulging. That bulging is called as a papillary muscle. So papillary muscle held this chordae tendineae, and chordae tendineae held this bicuspid and tricuspid valve at the proper position. And the margin of this ventricle, which is made up of columni carni, divide this ventricle into the smaller spaces, which is called as a fissures. Now, along with these four valves, you have to remember this Thebesian valve and Eustachian valve. Where this Thebesian valve is present, here we initially draw kiya tha coronary sinus. So this was a coronary sinus, and the opening of this coronary sinus was guarded, or opening of this coronary sinus is guarded by this Thebesian valve. Remember the name if you get question in your MCQ. So Thebesian valve is guarded by the opening of coronary sinus, and Eustachian valve is present here. You have a red color dot of dekh sakte. Eustachian valve is present at the opening of inferior vena cava. Now here again I have drawn the depression like structure. Yahan pe jo auricle hai, yahan pe there is a depression present. This depression during the fetal condition, this is auricle and ventricle. There is an opening between the right auricle and left auricle in fetus, that is called as a foramen ovale. Immediately after birth, this opening get closed, but the depression still remain. That is called as a fossa ovalis. Aapko ispe bhi question aate hai. What is a foramen ovale and what is a fossa ovalis? So foramen ovale kya hota hai? That is a opening present in the right and the left auricle, and wo opening immediately after birth close ho jata hai. That is called as a fossa ovalis. In some children or in some babies, just born babies, this opening doesn't get closed and it remains as it is. And that is leading to the blue baby syndrome. So where the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood get mixed. So hum log generally bolte hain heart mein hole hai. So that hole, because this opening, fossa ovalis ka opening close nahi hota hai, foramen ovale ka opening close nahi hota hai, fossa ovalis depression nahi banta hai. So that leads to the blue baby syndrome. So that is about the structure of the heart. In short, here I can show you in the model, heart is having the upper chamber, these are called as a auricle. Heart is having the lower chamber, that is called as a ventricle. Ventricle generally are thick walled. Kyun thick wall hota hai? Kyunki it has to distribute the blood. So as it is distributing the blood at a greater force, so it is a thick walled as compared to auricle. Now here you can see this chordae tendineae, a string chordae tendineae, which is attached to this muscle. Yahan pe jo bulging hua hai, which is attached to this muscle, that is called as a papillary muscle. And both of these held this काल यहाँ पे भी होता है एट अ प्रॉपर पोजिशन. इवन यू गेट क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ दिस कॉर्डी टेंडन. अलॉन्ग विद दिस हियर यू कैन सी द दिस सेमी ल्यूनर वाल. दिस सेमी ल्यूनर वाल वेयर विच आर द ओपनिंग ऑफ दिस इज गार्डेड. दिस ब्लू कलर इज अ पल्मोनरी सेमी ल्यूनर वाल एंड दिस रेड कलर इज अ एरोटिक सेमी ल्यूनर वाल. Now here from this particular region in the last video I have shown you this. This is the aorta which will lead to the systemic circulation and this is a pulmonary vein blue color which will lead to the pulmonary circulation. Aorta systemic circulation, pulmonary artery, this pulmonary artery will lead to the pulmonary circulation and hence